Very good evening to all. Myself, Dr. Bhavi Solanki, and my e-poster presentation topic is vitopsy, new developing science in the forensic odontology. So vitopsy is a word extracted from the two words, virtual and autopsy. Vitopsy is a virtual alternative to a traditional autopsy conducted with scanning and imaging technology. Vitopsy is a trademark registered by the Professor Richard Derenhofer. Now, if we see about the autopsy, conventional autopsy is an invasive procedure which includes dissection, interpretation, and cataloging. After performing the conventional autopsy procedure, the dead body is handed over to the family members for the last rituals to be performed. Afterwards, if the forensic odontologist wants to reconsider his or her decision, so it is quite difficult and not feasible. And possible mutilation occur during the conventional procedure. Because of these reasons, mostly family do not give positive consent for the traditional autopsy procedure. Even in some religion, they do not accept the procedure of the conventional autopsy procedure. Because of these pitfalls, we need to lead to the genesis of this vitopsy procedure. Even in this era of the COVID-19 pandemic, we all are getting used to this new normal things, like all our education classes are conducting online. We all are attending this conference online. The same way vitopsy helped in this era of COVID-19. Now we'll see the various procedure of the vitopsy in the forensic odontology. We can call it as a virtual dental autopsy, which is a real dentopsy. 3D surface scanning photogrammetry. It's a science with the help of which measuring can be done with the photographs. For that, we have to take photographs from the different angles and analyze in the software. In multi-slice computer tomography with the OPG, we can easily see the heart tissue in the multiple thin sections, and it aids in if there are any changes in the heart tissue. CBCT gives a useful source for the antemortem and the postmortem records, and it aids in the age estimation, gender determination, as well as the personal identification. MRI, with the help of MRI, we can examine the soft tissue and we can see if there are any changes in the soft tissue. Apart from that, nowadays we also use smart glasses, as yesterday Dr. Emilio mentioned, as well as there are certain new advances. They are not in the practical use, but there are concepts. There are concepts of vitro boards and vitro mobiles. They are the devices which integrate the various imaging modality and help in the vitopsy procedure. These vitro bots are basically virtual robots, and they are the gigantic machine. And this vitro mobile are a comparatively compact device, which is easily we can get into the site of the mass disaster. Now we'll see the advantages of the vitopsy procedure. As it's a scalpel free, it has become the faster procedure. There is a minimal risk of the infection to the forensic odontologist or the expert. 3D analysis can be done. Digital storage of the detail is possible. With the help of that, if the forensic odontologist want to have second opinion or reconsider something, so it is possible with this. And better cultural acceptance in the vitopsy procedure. As we know, every coin has the two sides. The same way, vitopsy also have its own demerits. Like for the procedure of the vitopsy, we have to do expensive investment, as well as the artifacts are difficult to identify and very fine structures cannot be studied. Order and color changes cannot be recorded. Even we are having some of this disadvantage, vitopsy in the forensic odontology, along with its scientific rationale and practical merits, it salutes and respects the religious and emotional sentiments of the various ethnic groups. It's a simple and non-invasive procedure and preserve the records for the longer duration. Because of these virtues, vitopsy is quickly gaining importance in the forensic odontology. Thank you so much.